Let me start by telling you all a story. A story of your neighbor. Darren and her family recently moved in a new city. Darren was around 15 years of age, who was a very sweet and kind girl. She happened to be your new neighbor. You were very excited about the fact that you'll have a new friend. This is about 3 weeks ago that your new neighbors moved in. Thereafter, whenever you saw Darren, you couldn't see her face as she wore a huge hoodie that lined up covering most of her face. You found it funny that someone would wear a jacket at such a time of the year when you cannot survive 15 minutes also without the air condition. What you found even funnier was that the jacket which she wore, which was 10 times her size. So the next day when you go to school, you tell your friends about this weird girl who wears a jacket in the summers which is 10 times her size. A few weeks had gone by and you and Darren became good friends by then. But still, that hoodie never wore off. You grew more and more curious day by day. Yesterday evening, like any other normal day, you and Darren were strolling in the park. No matter how much time you spent with her, her hoodie never wore off. You yourself found it weird to roam around with someone wearing a large hoodie all the time. You wanted to know what she looked like. You wanted to know why she wore a hoodie all the time. You wanted to know why she never showed her face. It was not like you ever saw anyone else in her house wear an extra large hoodie. You could no longer bear the curiosity and asked her that why would she wear a hoodie every time? Why would she not show her face to anyone? Why would she feel so insecure? She was quiet. No reply came from her side. You asked her once again, a bit loudly this time. Yet, she did not answer. You asked her again, this time very loudly. This time she placed her hand on her hoodie to take it off. You took a step closer to see her face. She took a few steps back, still being unsure. You then sympathized her and said that you were her friend, so she could trust you and she could believe you. So this was the moment you were waiting for. She slowly unveiled her hoodie. You were speechless. You broke into a cold sweat. You saw that she had a burnt face. The large hoodie which she wore covered most of her face in order to hide her burnt face. You were both angry and shocked at the same time, thinking how could you possibly roam around with such ugly person. Being very angry, you started running after her. Chased her till the edge of a cliff. Then her leg slipped and she fell off. I would just like to ask all of you one small question. What was more evil? Darren's half-burned face or her so-called friend? Well, good afternoon everyone. This is Rachi and this is what brings me to my topic today. Criticism. It doesn't matter what you do or how you choose to live your life. Whether you choose to go to a government school or a private school, be popular or choose not to be a popular, travel the world or live in a small town all your life, go to the gym 5 times a week or lay on the couch all day, someone will always judge you for it. There will always be haters and difficult people. For some reason or another, someone will always find a reason to project their insecurities and their fears onto you and your life. And you will have to deal with it. When we talk about haters and difficult people, the first thing that comes in our mind is criticism. But do you actually think that the negative people stop you from doing something you desire? Think about it once again. Well, if you still think so, you are wrong. The biggest critic in your life is you yourself. Nobody can stop you from doing something you really want to do. It's only you who can stop yourself. This is also known as the LKK syndrome or commonly known as the Log Kya Kahenge syndrome. The simplest way of getting past this obstacle is loving yourself and being proud of yourself. You ask how to deal with criticism? Firstly, love yourself and accept yourself. Secondly, follow the road, not the wall method. When asked for success of race car driving, many experts say that don't look at the wall. Your car goes where your eyes go. And the same can be said for your life while dealing with haters and critics. Criticism and negativity from people is like a wall. And if you focus on it, then you run right into it. Your mind will go where your action is focused. Criticism and negativity don't prevent you from finishing the night, but surely it will distract you. However, if you focus on the road in front of you and go on moving forward, Then you safely speed past the walls and the barriers that are nearby. Thirdly, if you choose to respond to others, then surprise them with kindness. It's always okay to talk about it. Finally, and most importantly, make the choices that are right for you. People will always criticize you either way. It's just you who needs to know how to deal with them. Thank you.